हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज सचिन प्रोफेसर एन एन तलपति फ्रॉम के केवा कॉलेज ऑफ टेक्नोलॉजी नासिक। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द मेम्ब्रेन सेपरेशन टेक्निक्स। ओके, सो इट इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट रिगार्डिंग टू द वाटर क्वालिटी। सो टुडे वी गोइंग टू सी अबाउट द मेम्ब्रेन प्रोसेस कैरेक्टराइजेशन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द मेम्ब्रेन प्रोसेस reverse osmosis, nanofiltration, ultrafiltration, microfiltration and membrane fouling. Okay, what exactly means membrane process? A membrane is selective barrier that permits the separation of certain species in a fluid by combination of sieving and diffusion mechanism. Membrane can be separated particles and the molecules and over wide particle size range and molecular weights. Okay, membrane is nothing but a barrier which permits the separation of certain species in the fluid by combination of sieving or naturally called as diffusion mechanism. Okay, membrane separation. In this slide we will see the solid particle is there, then solvent is there. Consider the solid particle is impurity and the solvent may be the what we say the water molecule. Okay, so what exactly the process is done by here by the membrane is to separate out the solid particle, the impurities from the solvent particles. Okay, it only permit solvent molecule through this separation medium. Okay, so whatever the waste, whatever the impurity is left behind. Okay, so whatever the feed is permitted through the membrane separation, it is only allow the solvent particles, that is water, and it will just screen out the solute particle. Okay, the whatever the pure form or pure liquid will get after the membrane separation, it is called as permit. Okay, so this is what the mechanism behind the membrane separation. It only allows certain fluid, a certain particle pass through the membrane. So introduction, let's have looks on an introduction. Membrane have gained an important place in the food technology and are used in the wide range of application. The key property that is exploited is the ability of membrane to control the permeation rate of the food through the membrane. In the separation application, the goal is allow one component of a mixture permission of the other component. Okay, so this is what the introduction about the membrane separation techniques. Membrane processes, there are commonly four membrane separation are there. First one is the reverse osmosis, then nanofiltration is there, ultrafiltration is there, microfiltration is there. Okay, so we will gonna see one by one in the next slide. Characteristic of filtration process. Okay, so reverse osmosis, nanofiltration, ultrafiltration and microfiltration, actually it is slightly changed in the size range of the filters, or what we can say the membranes. Okay, the separation principle is based on the size in the microfiltration, and if we see the ultrafiltration, nanofiltration, reverse osmosis, it is based on the size as well as the charges and affinity with the, in case of the nanofiltration and the reverse osmosis. If we see the size range of the membrane filter that is used in the reverse osmosis, it is about 1 nanometer. Okay, and in case of ultrafiltration, it is about 1 nanometer to the 100th nanometer, and microfiltration, it comes very reduction in the size range of the membrane separation, like 0.1 to 1 micrometer. Okay, so this is what the separation principle. Simply, microfiltration actually separate the molecule on the basis of the size, while this ultrafiltration, nanofiltration, reverse osmosis, it is separate the molecule on the basis of size as well as the charge and the affinity of the molecules. then processes technology, the typical operating pressure, then feed recovery and rejection rejected phases. Okay, here are four different type of the processes given, that is reverse osmosis, nanofiltration, ultrafiltration and microfiltration. Okay, that is first one is microfiltration, ultrafiltration, nanofiltration and reverse osmosis. The typical pressure, that is 0.5 to 2, and in case with the microfiltration, the this is what the bar pressure is used in the microfiltration, and so on it is get increased. Like in ultrafiltration it is like 1 to 5, in nanofiltration it is 30 to 15 bar, and in case of the reverse osmosis it is like 10 to 60 bars. Okay, feed recovery, microfiltration gives 90 to 99.9% feed recovery, while ultrafiltration gives 80 to 98%, nanofiltration gives 50 to 95%, while RO gives 30 to 90%. Okay, so whatever rejected species in the microfiltration, it reject all bacteria, cysts, spores. While in ultrafiltration, protein, viruses, exotoxins, pyrogens are is get rejected. Nanofiltration, sugar molecules, sugar particles or pesticides is there, it is get reduced, and here salts and some sugars is get reduced, rejected. So these are the types of membrane. We'll see in the figure, there is suspended solid is there, micromolecules there, multi ions is there, mono ion is there, and water is there. Okay, in microfiltration we can see only suspended solid are rejected, while other like macromolecule, multi ions or monovalent ions are get passed. In ultrafiltration only the suspended macromolecules are rejected, while other like monovalent ions and multivalent ions are get passed. In nanofiltration only the multi ions is rejected, but monovalent ions can be passed. Only the reverse osmosis is the step which reject all the suspended solids, micromolecules, multivalent ions and monovalent ions. Only it is pass a pure water through the membrane. Reverse osmosis is a type of water filtration process that involves the use of the osmotic pressure to remove certain element or element from water. Highly effective water purifying process called as reverse osmosis, and it is required pressure to force the pure water across a membrane, leaving impurities behind, capable of removing like 99% of the total dissolved solid, that is TDS, and 99% of all bacteria, thus providing safe pure water. So this is reverse osmosis, we can recommend for the process for the water purifications. The rejection water on the reverse osmosis unit is continuously referred to as the concentrate, the quality water which has passed through the membrane is referred as permit. Okay, so whatever the pure water is passed through the membrane, and it is nothing but the permit. So this is what the membrane that is consist like in the bar, like it have a perforated product tube, then anti-telescope cap, then field solution is there, permit carrier material is there, semi-permeable membrane is there, field water carrier is there. So this is what the membrane, some component of the membrane consists of. This is the small video about the RO system. So let's have a small look.
From one end of the vessel to the other. The membrane layer is extremely thin, It allows water to pass through or permeate, while preventing other compounds from passing through. Membranes remove molecules based on their size, shape, and charge. Generally, contaminants larger than water molecules will not pass through, including most chemical contaminants and all microorganisms such as viruses and bacteria. Two streams of water are produced. Pure, clean water or permeate flows across the membrane sheets and passes through the membrane layers to the inside core tube. Water that does not permeate becomes more highly concentrated with salts and other substances. This water is called concentrate. The pure permeate water flows out the core tube and one end of the pressure vessel, and the concentrate water flows out another outlet. The concentrate water can then flow into other pressure vessels for the same process to happen again, so even more pure permeate water can be recovered. About 82% of all the source of water becomes purified water.
So this is what the working of the RO system. It was a beautiful video. Okay, application of reverse osmosis. The largest commercial food application of the reverse osmosis is concentration of the whey from the cheese manufacturing, either the pre-concentration stage prior to the drying or for use in the manufacturing of ice cream. Reverse osmosis is also used to concentrate and purify fruit juices, enzyme fermentation, liquors and vegetable oils, as well as for the concentrated whey straw, citric acid, egg white, to clarify the wine, beer. So these are the few application of the reverse osmosis. Nanofiltration is again. Nanofiltration is a relatively recent membrane filtration process used in the often total dissolved solids, water such as surface water and groundwater. Nanofiltration is a cross flow filtration technology which ranges somewhere between ultrafiltration and reverse osmosis. Nominal pore size of membrane is about the 1 nanometer. Ultrafiltration, same pressure driving purification process in which membrane pore diameter is about 0.001 to 0.1 micromillimeter. Membrane perform affected by the concentration, polarization, membrane falling, membrane cleaning and operating pressure. Application of ultrafiltration is for dialysis in the blood treatments and concentration of the milk before cheese. So these are the some applications. Okay. Microfiltration is similar to the UV filtration by using lower pressure than the RO, but it is distinguished by the larger range of particle size, that is 0.1 to 10 micrometer. It is pore size of porous membrane that is used in the microfiltration. What exactly mean the membrane falling? Membrane falling is the gathering of undesirable material deposited on the solid surface which harm the function of membrane. It is nothing but the impurity that is covered with the membrane that will harm to the system. Okay, the falling can be consist of the organism called up by falling. For the falling can be non-living substances. It may be cause the deposition, okay, in the system, in the membrane. So it is very important to check all the time, to take a quality inspection every time of the membrane, whether it is supposed to avoid the falling. There are various ways to reduce the falling, such as periodic pulsing of field, periodic pulsing filtrate, increase the shear and rotating membrane, vibrating membrane. So this is what about the membrane processes. Okay, thank you so much.